Our top focus, Delhi air quality has hit the skids. The morning AQI number stand well above 400, which has been further exacerbated by haze and fog amid dipping temperatures. Currently, 31 of the 38 stations are recording an AQI in severe category, way beyond the 400 mark. And the situation is no better in other national capital regions, whether we're talking about Noida, Greater Noida, Gurugram, Ghaziabad, all of them are trading in the very poor category of AQI, which an average would mean around 350 plus. But the visibility has also dropped substantially. You can look at the visuals on your screens, making commute extremely difficult. Several flights and trains have also been delayed amid reduced visibility. But mind you, this is only the beginning, as worse lies ahead. However, in spite of action, the apex body to monitor air pollution, that is the CAQM, also known as the Commission for Air Quality Management, is prioritizing to be in the wait and watch mode. Why is that? Well, the CAQM has blamed it on extreme fog and decided against implementing Stage 3 of GRAP. As it says, the panel hopes that the AQI will improve to very poor category.
The national capital is yet again waking up to severe air quality. Remember, the AQI this morning is around 432. And this is not just a problem for the national capital. Noida, Greater Noida, Gurgaon, Ghaziabad, these regions in the national capital are all recording an AQI in the very poor category as well. Currently, I'm reporting from an elevated flyover here in Noida. And around me, our camera person, Mrityunjay, will be showing you visuals of the dense smog situations that's engulfed the entire city at this point. Now, on your screens, you'll be able to see the roads and how the other buildings are all shrouded in this heavy layer of dense smog. Remember, these are the areas that are popular now. Noida is popular for its high rises, residential areas, and none of these buildings this morning is visible. And we are mere meters away from them. Also requesting our camera person to pan and give you the visual of the NTPC building. That is just a few meters away from us. And you'll be able to see the dense fog that has shrouded even the building that's closest to us at the moment. Also, when we pan towards the Sector 20 area, towards our left as well, all we see is fog all around us. And remember, this is mixed with a cocktail of pollutants that right now are recording an AQI in the very poor category, especially for Noida. The digits range from 372 early in the morning. Remember, this is the time where we generally experience calmer winds, which is why the pollutants are also trapped. On your screens, you can also see the early morning traffic, people who are commuting to their offices, their place of work, how the headlights of a lot of vehicles have been left on, and this is because how severely the visibility has been affected. And remember, when the visibility is affected, it also leads to increased pollution because congestion tends to increase, snarls tends to increase, and it is a constant problem that we have been witnessing in not just the national capital, but in fact in the entire national capital region.
All right, Kritika Tiwari, my colleague who just filed that report as well, joins me this morning. Kritika, good to be in conversation with you once again. In terms of the fact that, you know, there are other driving factors that are contributing to this, while you, of course, will speak about the numbers, talk about how it's looking like while you report your mast up, which only goes on to show what the reality is looking like. When I had that opportunity to talk to you about why this is happening, if you would help our viewers better understand that perspective.
Right, so over the previous days, we had been seeing that the national capital and, in fact, the larger northern India region, in fact, has been witnessing very calm wind speeds. What this means is basically that the dispersion of pollutants is quite low. We did see, however, in the last week, the wind speed pick up to 10 kilometers per hour during certain hours, which is why the AQI in Delhi specifically slipped closer to under the 350 category. But yesterday, again, with the dense fog that you'll also be able to see on your screens right now, we are currently near the flyover towards the Akshardham temple, and how barely an outline of the temple right now this morning is visible. All the high rises that we had been reporting about for the past few days are all densely covered with this thick layer of smog. Now what is happening is that as per the decision support system, the contribution to the PM2.5 levels have in fact, because of stubble burning, reached to 18%. The contribution of transport and vehicular emissions is also closer to 13%. Now, more than that, the issue is also of how during winters, the cold air tends to trap in the local emissions that emerge not only just out of Delhi, but also from multiple NCR cities as well. And that, because of the cold air and then the atmospheric above, atmospheric layer above, forms a sort of an airshed, which makes the city and the regioning neighboring areas also quite vulnerable to poor air quality. However, this is not something that is just unique to Delhi. There are other areas in the world as well which face similar geographical challenges. Despite that, year after year we see these number peak. The more unfortunate aspect is that as and when the fog situations keep getting denser and we start seeing a decline in the minimum and maximum temperatures as well, the situation is only going to be exacerbated because the trapping of pollutants also happen at a faster rate. So far, what we've been able to see is whenever the wind speed picks up, that's when the AQI dips closer to the initial digits of the very poor category. Also, it has been dipped into the moderately polluted categories in a few pockets of Delhi. But as of this now, almost all stations are recording an AQI in the severe or near to severe category, which is extremely critical for the long-time respiratory health of the citizens of this region. Now, we have seen how studies have linked shorter lifespans with the exposure, long-term exposure to these pollutants as well. Some residents have talked to us about their want of shifting to a place outside of Delhi for these months. But again, this is a luxury that only very few people can afford. And practically also, you can't just desert your place of residence because the air quality gets this bad. But year after year, we're seeing residents come to us with these issues and there seems to be no respite in sight. Last year as well, we saw that even well towards January, AQI of 413 was recorded somewhere in the early half of January itself. So that is, this is the extent till which we can see the severe levels also continue. Of course, rainfall does help, but experts have also told us how multiple pollutants are hydrophobic. That is, sprinkling of water sprinklers and using anti-smog guns is also not capable of trapping all pollutants. However, what we do need, in fact, especially for a city as busy as Delhi, is in fact measures that can work year-round. This is also something that the opposition, the Delhi BJP, has also been alleging.
And that is where I think we have to have people in power questionable and ask them accountability, because at the end of the day, there are policies, like we have said multiple times, you yourself while reporting have stated the same, but why is it that it's not being implemented to the tune where we don't get to see what we're seeing? Now, hoping that this year at least is a lesson for the next